गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू। ओके लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द नेक्स्ट सिलेबिक पॉइंट। ओके यस्टरडे वी हैव फिनिश्ड द इंफॉर्मेशन सिस्टम डेवलपमेंट एंड द प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट। ओके इन दैट टॉपिक वी हैव स्टडीड द व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय द इंफॉर्मेशन सिस्टम डेवलपमेंट, वेरियस फेजेस ऑफ द इंफॉर्मेशन सिस्टम डेवलपमेंट, then what is project management, and yesterday only we have covered the need of the project management. Okay, now today our next topic is related with the managing the data resources. Okay, now up till now we have studied the everything details related with the what do you mean by the information system, in that we have studied, and so also we have compared the traditional information system and the modern information system, and nowadays we are focusing on the modern information system, that is nothing but the computerized information system. Also we have studied the resources required or the components of the modern information system. Which are the components of the modern information system? Components of the information system are which? Yes, we have studied in the first unit components of the information system. Which are the components? Yes,
hardware, software, hardware,
peoples, data, network, etc. Correct. Now, in that, one of the important resource is nothing but the data. Okay, and our today's session is related with the managing the data resource. Okay, managing in the sense how you control or handle the particular that important resource, that is the data. Okay, now if you see the kind of data available nowadays and the kind of data which were available before 10 years, which data is more? If you compare the today's data available as compared to the data which were available before 10 years, which data is more? Yes? Today's data is huge, and that's why we are referring the today's kind of data available in the market as a big data. Okay. So huge amount of data is available. And as we know, for the information system, the main resource is nothing but the data. Okay. Now, in the industry field or in the business field, as you can see, there is a rapid growth. There is a huge growth in the industry field from the last 10 years or the 20 years, we can see. And also there is a role of the computer has also increased. All of you agree?
Yes, sir.
So there I have written the first statement here. The rapid growth in the industrialization and the computerization has created. Now, as a you can see, the data has increased. The managing that data is also one particular challenge we are having. Correct?
Yes.
Okay. So in case of the information system, our main source is main resource is nothing but the data. And as the data is increasing in high amount, our main challenge in front of information management or information system management is nothing but managing this particular high amount of data or managing this huge amount of data. Okay. Now you can see in any business, okay, in any business, okay, or any industry, okay, there are the different functional department are you there. Okay, functional department in the sense you can see there are the sales department, correct? Then we have the purchase department. Then we have the manufacturing department. Okay, marketing department, likewise, finance, HR department, administration, etc., etc. These all the departments are referred as the functional department of certain industry or the business. Okay, got the point. Now consider, in this business we are utilizing the information system. Okay, and each of these department are having the information system for their use. Okay, getting the situation, each of these departments are having their information system for use. Okay, now my question to you, the data which is available at this department, data which is available at this department, at this different department, okay, from where the data will be get collected for this different department? That is my question. Okay, first we need to understand each of these department is having the information system. All of you are agree?
Yes, sir.
Now my question is what? As we know, the information system can give you the better result if it is having the data available. It processes that data and we get the good information. Okay. Now my question, from where these different functional department will get the data? What will be the source of data? What will be the source of data for all these department? That is my question. Yes, you got the meaning of source of data. Source of data means what? Yes.
Source of data.
Ha, mag ya sagaya he je vegvegle department ahet yanna data kutun milnar ahe? That is my question. कारण इथे ज्या इन्फॉर्मेशन सिस्टीम आहेत त्यांना डेटा जर मिळाला नाही तर त्या वर्क करतील का व्यवस्थित?
नो
नो. सो फ्रॉम वेअर दे विल गेट द डेटा, दॅट इज माय क्वेश्चन. व्हॉट विल बी द सोर्स ऑफ डेटा फॉर ऑल दिस डिपार्टमेंट? येस, व्हॉट विल बी द सोर्स ऑफ डेटा फॉर ऑल दिस डिपार्टमेंट? Now each of these department is having their different role, function, correct? Okay, all these department are having their different functions, or they are functioning in the same way?
Different function.
So data needed for them will also be different.
Yes, sir.
Okay, and so our next point is nothing but, related with this functional, all functional department that we have just shown you, the data is being collected from the different sources. Okay, from different sources. Okay, and which are that different sources? Here I have mentioned that different sources from where data is being collected for this different functional department. Now which are the different sources? General surveys conducted by that businesses. General surveys from the customer, vendor, supplier. Here you can take the example of mobile companies. Okay, now even if you go to the any online site of the mobile company, they used to ask you your feedback about their product.
Yes, sir.
That is nothing but the review. That is nothing but the kind of survey they are doing. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So the review given by you or feedback given by the customer is nothing but the kind of data. Correct?
Yes, sir.
So that is nothing but the main source of data for these different departments, as I mentioned here, that is the general surveys, articles written by the different businessmen, articles in the sense lake, okay, related with the businesses, books written by the different scientists related with the businesses, social sites. Can social site is also the source of data for the businesses?
Yes, sir.
Yes, because on the different social site, you can see the Twitter, Facebook, WhatsApp, etc. On these different social site, people are used to share their views about certain product. So that also become the source of data. Different websites, this is also the source of data. Various kind of shopping sites, like as I said, the Amazon, Flipkart, etc., and the customer reviews on that. Government records related with the different products, companies, etc. Technical magazines. I hope you are getting the meaning of technical magazines. Yes, what do you mean by the technical magazines? Yes, technical magazine means what? Technical magazines or business magazines? Magazines in the sense what? Magazines? Have you read the magazines? Any kind of magazines? Marathi, Hindi, have you read? Yes. Magazines means what? Tejas. Yes.
Dictionary.
Dictionary. Yes, Suraj.
Read just like a book.
अरे तुम्ही मॅगझिन वगैरे वाचत नाही का असे आपले टेक्निकल रिलेटेड
न्यूजपेपर
हा जमदाडे
न्यूजपेपर न्यूजपेपर
न्यूजपेपरला मॅगझिन म्हणू का आपण
तुम्हाला
एक मराठी फॉर लेडीज लेट मी गिव्ह द वन एक सहेली एक नावाचं मॅगझिन असतं बघा तुमच्या लेडीज साठी ऐकलंय का नाही कधी
नेटवर सर्च केल्यावर येत ना
अरे
कंटेंट्स आर्टिकल
हार्ड कॉपी मध्ये सुद्धा तुम्हाला मिळतात असे आपल्या कॉलेजचं मॅगझिन वाचलंय का तुम्ही कॉलेजच्या रिलेटेड आपल्या ज्या वर्षभरात ऍक्टिव्हिटी होतात त्याच्या रिलेटेड आपण सगळ्या गोष्टी त्याच्यामध्ये टाकतो गॅदरिंगच्या वेळेस तुमच्याकडून डेटा मागवतात बघा कुणी कविता केली असेल कुणी लेख लिहिला असेल कुणी जोक लिहिले असेल दीज ऑल द थिंग्स आर कंटेन इन दॅट मॅगझिन बट टेक्निकल मॅगझिन्स ऑर द बिझनेस मॅगझिन्स आर व्हॉट वेअर द डिफरंट सायंटिस्ट ऑर द डिफरंट ऑथर्स हॅव एक्सप्रेस देअर व्ह्यूज रिलेटेड विथ द बिझनेस प्रोडक्ट एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा कधीतरी लायब्ररीमध्ये जावं आपल्याला तिथं विचारा त्यांना की आम्हाला मॅगझिन्स वाचायचे computer science related got the point when you come into the college do the first thing is go to the library and ask them we want to read some kind of magazines related with the computer science will you do that yes
yes sir yes.
tumhala mahit hai ka aapla library madhe magazines ahet computer science related
yes sir
kadhi gelay kuni tumhi vachlet kadhi magazines te नाही कधीच नाही नाव दिस इज व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट थिंग्स गाईज ओके यू मस्ट रीड दिस एक्स्ट्रा थिंग्स रिलेटेड विथ द अवर ब्रँच ओके डिफरंट ब्रँच इज हॅविंग देअर डिफरंट टेक्निकल मॅगझिन्स अवेलेबल सो सेम वे रिलेटेड विथ द बिझनेसेस ऑल्सो डिफरंट काइंड ऑफ मॅगझिन्स आर अवेलेबल वेअर आय टोल्ड यू वेअर डिफरंट बिझनेस मन ऑथर सायंटिस्ट हॅव शेअर देअर व्ह्यूज रिलेटेड विथ द बिझनेसेस प्रोडक्ट एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा दॅट ऑल्सो इज वन ऑफ द सोर्स ऑफ डेटा Financial newspapers is also one of the great source of data. Do you know the any kind of financial newspaper? Yes. Do you know the any kind of financial newspaper? What is? Yes. Jamdade. Have you heard about the Economic Times? Jamdade, switch off your mic. Yes, have you heard about the Economic Times newspaper? ऐकले का जसे आपले मराठी मधले न्यूज पेपर असतात लोकमत पुढारी लोक लाईक दिस काइंड ऑफ थिंग सो रिलेटेड विथ द बिझनेस देर इज अ पॉप्युलर न्यूज पेपर यूज टू बी पब्लिश एव्हरी डे दॅट इज द इकॉनॉमिक टाइम्स आय एम गिविंग द एक्झाम्पल After this finishing of the lecture, you must search on the internet. On the internet also, you can read this kind of newspapers, Economic Times. Okay. So, my point of discussion is what? These are the various sources of data. You got this point? Sources of data?
Yes, sir.
So, from these various sources, data is collected for these all the different functional department. Okay. Now, after data is collected, main thing is nothing but how this data is get managed how this data is get handled using that information system by that particular business or the company if all this data is not get handled properly not get managed properly then we will not able to get the correct result the correct output that we are expecting from the information system Got this point? Okay. So after collection of this, all this data, it is very important thing to handle or to manage this data in the particular way, because as already we have discussed number of times, the success of any business or the organization or industry depends on what they do with that particular data. What success depends on what they actually do with that particular data. If data is available in the huge amount, but that data is not get handled, managed, analyzed properly, will that business company will get the benefit of that data? That is my question. Yes. If data collected from the various sources, if not get handled, analyzed, managed properly, will that company will get the benefit of that data?
No.
So that is the point I am mentioning here. Success of any business organization depends on how they handle that data, manage that data, analyze that data. Understood. So here I have mentioned the organization effectiveness depends on ability of that business enterprises to store that data, organize that data, and manage that different data which is now available. Okay. Now the point we have just discussed before, each function, there are the different functional departments are there. Okay. Like I have mentioned, sales, purchase, then accounting, finance, etc. So these are the various functional department. Now, is it possible that this different functional department may have, in some cases, they may have same kind of data available everywhere? It can happen or not? What I said, there are the different functional department like sales, okay, purchase, financial, accounting, etc., etc. हे सगळे डिपार्टमेंट, हे जे फंक्शनल डिपार्टमेंट आहेत, याच्यामध्ये असं होऊ शकतं का कधी कधी की त्यांच्याकडे सगळ्या डिपार्टमेंट कडे काहीतरी एक सेम डेटा अवेलेबल असू शकतो? असं होऊ शकतं का? As we know, the different departments having their different functionality, but sometimes it can happen, and it happen number of times, different departments may have some sort of data. I am not talking about the all the data. All data is same for all these departments. All data is available as the same for all these department. Some kind of data might be available to the different department which is same. Like we can say information related with the customer, name of the customer, his mobile number, etc., etc. So some kind of data might be available to the different to these different department as the same kind of data. Now, if this same kind of data is available to this different department, now what is the challenge to handle this data? And if this same kind of data is available, is it the beneficial thing or it is the disadvantageous thing? Yes? What I'm saying, if same kind of data, some kind of data is available to this different department as a what? Same copy of that data. Then is it the beneficial or the disadvantageous? Yes?
Disadvantageous.
Na? If there is a same kind of data, not all the data. Okay, this is important. Not all the data, some sort of data. Okay, consider 10% of data is available as the same for all these department, then it is nothing but the data redundancy. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
What do you mean by the data redundancy?
The duplication.
Duplication. Same kind of data is available. Same kind of data is available in the different functional department. That is called as what? The data redundancy. So it is not the beneficial. So the challenge, one main challenge in case of the handling or managing the data resources, what to manage that this kind of same kind of data from the different department. And now how it can be managed? You know, to manage these, we need to collect the data from these multiple system. Yes or no? What we need to do? We need to collect the data from these multiple system, okay, and build the single set of data from these. You are getting my point? Yes. How can manage this kind of problem of data redundancy? Yes. How can manage this? By collecting the data from these multiple system. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
As a single set of data. फेजर सगळ्या फेजर आता मी जसं तुम्हाला सांगितलं की मल्टिपल सिस्टीम कुठे आहेत मल्टिपल डिपार्टमेंट्स मध्ये आहेत तर त्या मल्टिपल डिपार्टमेंटचा डेटा आपण काय करणार एकाच ठिकाणी कलेक्ट करणार यू आर गेटिंग माय पॉइंट
यस सर
तर मग एकाच ठिकाणी कलेक्ट केल्यानंतर डेटा रिडंडन्सी राहील का तिथं
नो सर
नाही ना मग त्याच्यावर आपल्याला एक डिफरंट ऑपरेशन परफॉर्म करावं लागतील दॅट वी स्टडी नेक्स्ट बट वन मेन चॅलेंज अवेलेबल रिलेटेड विथ द मॅनेजिंग द डेटा रिसोर्सिस वॉट If such kind of data redundancy is there, as the same copy of data is available in the different functional department, then in order to handle that, it is required to collect these all the data from multiple system as a single set of data on the single system. Understood? Then that kind of data redundancy problem can be handled. Now my question is, what data redundancy can happen or not? In the today's now huge amount of data is getting collected related with that data redundancy can occur or not before collecting it to the single system that is question yes if the data is collected from the different sources just we have discussed for the different departments different functional departments data redundancy will happen or not
yes sir
data redundancy will happen because that is not when we are going to analyze the data when that all the data were collected together then we are going to analyze the data understood so initially that all the data is we are going to collect that is nothing that is going to be data in that data redundancy might be there duplication might be there incorrectness might be there irrelevantness might be there yes or no
yes
yes
sir. so managing all these things what data duplication irrelevantness incorrectness duplication that is nothing but the managing the data resources got the point
yes sir
yes so One solution that we are discussing here to collect these all the data from multiple system as a single set of data. Okay, next we will discuss related with that techniques of managing this data. Okay, and so same thing I have mentioned here, the business organization or enterprises has to ensure that it does not use the multiple version of the same piece of data in different parts of its operation. So in order to avoid these things, it is required to merge these records into the this is a very important statement so in order to avoid this part which part to utilizing the multiple versions of the same piece of data in different parts of its operation how it can be avoided merging these all the records into the single authenticated master file got the point yes data from this multiple system has to be done what has to be merge in the sense what merging means what
combine
karna all data combine karna
yes
mang to jo all data combine kela jata tela ek naav dile jata this is a technical name for this single authenticated master file what single authenticated master file and where this single authenticated master file will be there on the server in short Got the point?
Yes, sir.
On the main computer, and from this main computer, data will be shared to the all the functional department. It will be like this. Let me show you. This will be your single authenticated file on this computer. From this, it will be get shared to the different functional department. Is it the beneficial? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Is the data redundancy duplication होईल का नाही होणार?
No.
इथं सिक्युरिटी प्रोव्हाइड करणे इझी होईल का येस डिफरंट फंक्शनल डिपार्टमेंटला सिक्युरिटी प्रोव्हाइड करणे आणि इथं सिंगल सिस्टमला प्रोव्हाइड करणे विच इज द मोर बेनिफिशियल? येस, विच इज सिंगल सिस्टम. इथं आपण हिअर वी कॅन गिव्ह द बेटर सिक्युरिटी. शेअरिंग इथं इझी होईल का नाही? द शेअरिंग विल बिकम इझी, येस ऑर नो?
येस सर.
येस, सो दॅट इज द मेन व्हॉट वी कॅन से आस्पेक्ट ऑफ मॅनेजिंग द data. If the data is present on multiple system, there might be the chances of the data redundancy, duplication, etc., etc. Now to avoid that, all the data must be get merged together and it is being referred as a single authenticated master file. So that is the one good approach to handle the or manage the data reserves. Okay, so here I have mentioned the same thing. Once the master file is in place, once we create the master file, the employees and all the application can easily access this single view of the enterprise data. Understood? Now these all the things we are not possible in the traditional information system. Traditional information system madhe asa karta ala asta ka sanga mala?
No, sir.
No, because there was no utilization of the computer. All these things become possible because now we have the computer to be get utilized. Understood? And now after collecting this data at a one place in the single master authenticated file, this data need to be reorganized into the certain standard format rules. It need to be get analyze, update, etc., etc. So after collecting this data at this single master file, there is a need to perform different operation on this data. That is the main way of managing the data. Okay, what? Now consider we have collected this data at the single place. Now it will get shared to the different departments. Now before it gets shared to the different departments, different operation need to be performed on this data. Because data is what? What is the definition of data we have seen? Is the data is directly usable?
No, sir.
No, data is the raw form. In order to make that data usable, we need to perform different operation on that data using the different kind of techniques. Understood? And that is nothing but our next point of discussion. Here you can see managing the data resource consists of these following important techniques. As I told you, now data is available at the single place or getting collected. Now next thing is nothing but we need to manage that data. Now when you are collecting this data together, there is a different techniques are being need to be get performed, different operation need to be get performed, and that is nothing but the main way of managing the data resource. Now which are that techniques when you are collecting this data together and when you are analyzing this data, which are that different techniques? That techniques are nothing but the techniques for the managing data resource. Now which are the techniques? In that first technique related with the managing the data source, data resource is nothing but what? Data migration. What? Data migration. What do you mean by the data migration, Deen? Data migration is one of the technique of managing the data resource. What is your view related to the data migration? Migration means what? Yes. Migration means what?
Data transfer from one place to another.
As I said, if you want to collect data at center place, first thing that we need to perform is what? Data migration. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So data migration is nothing but what? Process of moving the data from one location to the another. So as I said, these are the various separate departments are there, functional departments. Yes. As I said, in order to avoid that data duplication, redundancy, etc., etc., what we need? We need to collect the data from different department. Got the point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And when you collect this data from different departments, from different location, that technique is called as what? Data migration. Got the point?
Yes, sir.
So that this is the first technique of managing the data resource, data migration. So in this different department, is it possible that data might be present in another format, correct? Yes or no? With this
Department,
data might be available in the different format, in different syntax. It can happen or not?
Yes, sir.
So data migration also consists of transforming the data from one format into the another format. Got the point?
Yes, sir.
So this is nothing but the first technique of managing the data resource, that is the data migration, process of moving data from one location to the another. So same thing I have mentioned here. So this result of this is nothing but when we need to perform the data migration, when we have the new computers available, or when we change the location of data in that case, and when you are collecting the data together from the multiple system, in that every case we need to do the data migration. If you want to change the format of data from one format to another format, in that case also there is a need to perform the data migration. Understood? In one more important case, the data migration get performed, and that is nothing but this I have mentioned here. And this is nowadays is getting performed. Now, when you change the premise infrastructure of your information system, when you change the infrastructure premise of your information system, means what? Now, what do you mean by the changing the infrastructure premise of your information system? What is the meaning of this? Changing the infrastructure premise of your information system. What is the meaning of this? Let me give the example. Now you have the company, you are using the information system there. There are the different functional system, functional department. Okay. And initially you need to collect the data from all these functional department. That is the case of the data migration, et cetera, et cetera. Now, what is the case of this change in the infrastructure premise? Now you are storing the data on the server, which is present in your company. I am calling it as a master file here. Yes. And from here, the data is getting shared in the different department. Okay. This is the case we are studying. Now consider you want to put that data on the cloud. Yes. All of you are getting me? Instead of putting this data on the physical machine, which is available in your company, instead of that, you want to put data on where? On the cloud. What is meaning of this? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Can we utilize the data which is put on the cloud for our company?
Yes, sir.
बरोबर ना. इथं मी काय सांगतो की आपल्या कंपनी मधल्या फिजिकल सर्व्हरवर डेटा ठेवण्यापेक्षा आपण कुठे ठेवतोय? क्लाउडवर. क्लाउड म्हणजे काय? व्हॉट इज क्लाउड? येस. व्हॉट इज मीनिंग ऑफ क्लाउड? येस गाइस. तेजस.
ऑनलाइन डेटा स्टोर करायचं.
आपण काय करतोय? आपले मशीन यूज न करता इंटरनेटवर कुठेतरी आपण ते काय करतोय? आपला डेटा स्टोअर करतोय. यू आर गेटिंग द पॉइंट? इज इट दॅट इज नथिंग बट द चेंज इन द इन्फ्रास्ट्रक्चर प्रिमाइस? येस ऑर नो? येस. हिअर वी आर युटिंग द इन्फ्रास्ट्रक्चर ऑफ अवर कंपनी इट सेल्फ. हिअर यू आर युजिंग द इन्फ्रास्ट्रक्चर ऑफ विच इज अवेलेबल ऑन द इंटरनेट दॅट मेड बी प्रोव्हाइड बाय द डिफरंट कंपनीज. दॅट इन्फ्रास्ट्रक्चर इज नथिंग बट द cloud-based storage you are utilizing. Here I have mentioned what you are utilizing: cloud-based storage. And when you have to shift from your own company server to cloud, is there the requirement of the data migration? That is my question. Yes.
Yes, sir. Required.
रिक्वायर ना. आपल्याकडे जातो, आपल्याला तिथे ट्रान्सफर करावं लागेल ना डेटा. गेटिंग द पॉइंट?
यस सर.
सो दॅट इज नथिंग बट द वन ऑफ द टेक्निक रिलेटेड टू द मॅनेजिंग द डेटा सोर्स, दॅट इज व्हॉट डेटा मायग्रेशन. आय होप ऑल ऑफ यू हॅव गॉट दिस पॉइंट. येस.
यस सर.
ओके, लेट्स मूव टू द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट. सेकंड इम्पॉर्टंट टेक्निक इज द डेटा रिकन्सिलेशन. हॅव यू हर्ड द वर्ड रिकन्सिलेशन बिफोर दिस? Now, in the previous case, we have seen the data migration. Data migration can be required even you are not moving the data to the cloud also. Yes or no? I told you the two cases where the data migration required. One case is what? One case when you are collecting the data from the different functional department. Barobar? Second case काय की तुम्हाला तुमच्या कंपनी मधला सर्वर वर डेटा ठेवायचा नाही, कुठे ठेवायचा आहे? क्लाउड वर ठेवायचा. तिथे सुद्धा डेटा मायग्रेशन रिक्वायर्ड.
यस सर.
नाउ सेकंड टेक्निक इज क्वाइट रिलेटेड विथ द फर्स्ट टेक्निक, दॅट इज द डेटा रिकन्सिलेशन, विच इज नथिंग बट एज यू आर मूविंग द डेटा, वी टेक द वी कॅरी ऑन द विथ एक्झाम्पल ऑफ डेटा मायग्रेशन, एक्झाम्पल ऑफ फ्रॉम द अवर कंपनी सर्वर टू द क्लाउड बेस सर्वर. ओके, एज यू आर मूविंग द डेटा फ्रॉम युअर कंपनी server and the system to the cloud. Now it is required whether the same data which is available here is being get transferred here, or is there any changes happening in this data as compared with this data. He verification karna garjecha aahe ki nahi, what do you think? Karan apan itun jave data move karnare, migrate karnare kuta cloud var, तो डेटा इंटरनेट थ्रू ट्रान्सफर होणार आहे. यू आर गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? तर मग तो डेटा मध्ये चेंज होऊ शकतो की नाही? कुणीतरी हॅक करून काहीतरी चेंजेस होऊ शकतात का नाही त्या डेटा मध्ये? होऊ शकतात ना.
हो सर.
सो दॅट इज द पॉइंट वेअर द डेटा रिकन्सिलेशन इज रिक्वायर्ड. दॅट इज नथिंग बट इट इज डेटा रिकन्सिलेशन इज डिफाइन एज व्हॉट? द प्रोसेस ऑफ व्हेरिफिकेशन ऑफ डेटा ड्युरिंग द डेटा मायग्रेशन. गेटिंग द पॉइंट?
Yes, sir.
Simple thing, let me tell you, it is nothing but the comparison of the source data with the destined data. Yes or no? आपण डेटा ट्रान्सफर करतोय, मायग्रेट करतोय या पोझिशन वरून या पोझिशनला, या लोकेशनला. येस ऑर नो? करेक्ट. वी आर मायग्रेटिंग डेटा फ्रॉम हियर टू हियर. So it is yes, all of you get current again. Now what second technique we are discussing related with the managing the data, that is the data reconciliation. Yes, tell me what we understood. Yes. The data reconciliation,
sir, data transfer karताना ते,
ha आता आपण पहिली टेक्निक, दिस टेक्निक आपण काय डिस्कस केली की डेटा मायग्रेशन. तिथे काय होतं की वी नीड टू कलेक्ट द डेटा फ्रॉम डिफरंट डिपार्टमेंट्स, दॅट इज द कॉल्ड एज द डेटा मायग्रेशन. और इवन if you want to transfer the data on the cloud, if you want to use the cloud service, that is also called as the data migration. So during this data migration, it is required to verify whether the same data is being transferred from this location to this location. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Whether there are any changes happen, if any changes, can the changes happen? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Changes can happen because if anybody hacker or the cracker try to crack your system and try to make the changes in system, he can completely change your data. It can happen or not?
Yes, sir, it happen.
And jar tani change kela tar aplyala benefit milel ka? Tya company na information system kadun je benefit milnar hote te benefit miltil ka?
No, sir.
So that is nothing but the concept of data reconciliation. It is the process of verifying the data which is transferred from the source location to the destination. Got the point?
Yes, sir.
So here same thing I have mentioned, in this process, in which process? Reconciliation process. Target data kutla apla ithe, yes or no? In this case, correct. This is the target data and this is the source data. Yes?
Yes, sir.
So yes, sir. It is the process where the target data is compared with the source data to ensure that the migration has done ट्रान्सफरिंग ऑफ डेटा करेक्टली. अंडरस्टूड. आता मी जसं तुम्हाला सांगितलं की फर्स्ट केस की हे डिफरंट आपले फंक्शनल डिपार्टमेंट आहेत, बरोबर? ऑल ऑफ यू आर एबल टू सी? यस. Yes, all of you can able to see this diagram.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
हे काय आता मी फर्स्ट केस काय सांगितली होती तुम्हाला की ह्या फंक्शनल डिपार्टमेंट मधून आपण डेटा कुठे घेतो अगोदर मेन फाईलला मास्टर फाईल. येस ऑर नो?
येस
सर. मग इथून ह्या सेपरेट फंक्शनल डिपार्टमेंट कडून ज्यावेळेस आपण डेटा इथं कलेक्ट करतो त्यावेळेस सुद्धा डेटा रिकन्सिलेशन प्रोसेस रिक्वायर्ड आहे की नाही सांगा मला. आहे ना? कारण इथं काय होईल, हा टार्गेट होईल, टार्गेट डेटा आणि हे काय होतील, सगळे सोर्स होतील, करेक्ट?
यस
सर. सो हियर ऑल्सो देर इज अ नीड ऑफ द डेटा रिकन्सिलेशन. सो डेटा, आय होप ऑल ऑफ यू गॉट द पॉइंट. रिकन्सिलेशन नथिंग बट द व्हेरिफिकेशन ऑफ डेटा ड्युरिंग द मायग्रेशन ऑफ डेटा. सेकंड टेक्निक अंडरस्टूड?
यस.
देन लेट्स मूव टू द नेक्स्ट, दॅट इज द डेटा consolidation. That already we have discussed, here the technical name is given, data consolidation. That is nothing but what? As we know, the data is generated from the various sources. Collecting this data in different format together, that is nothing but called as the data consolidation. Consolidation in the sense, combining that data together, okay, at some single location. Which is also referred as the data warehouse or the data lake. I hope all of you have heard about the word data warehouse. What do you mean by data warehouse? Yes.
Data store karne.
Data eka thikani store karne. Barobar. Yes, Yogesh.
Sir.
डेटा
वेअर करणे,
एकाच ठिकाणी काय करणे, डेटा, त्यालाच काय म्हणतात डेटा कन्सोलिडेशन. दॅट इज ऑल्सो रिफर्ड एज ऑट द डेटा कन्सोलिडेशन. दॅट इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टंट टेक्निक इन द मॅनेजिंग द डेटा रिसोर्सेस. अंडरस्टूड? देन
दिस
इज द थर्ड टेक्निक, दॅट इज द ओके सिम्पल कलेक्टिंग द डेटा फ्रॉम व्हेरियस सोर्सेस दॅट ऑलरेडी वी हॅव डिस्कस टुगेदर, दॅट इज द डेटा कन्सोलिडेशन. अँड नेक्स्ट इम्पॉर्टंट थिंग, डेटा क्लिन्सिंग, fourth technique, what? Data cleansing. Now consider, we have collected the data from different sources together, okay? Now don't get confused between the data consolidation and the data migration. Can anybody tell me the what difference is there, or both are the same thing? Yes, what I'm asking, what is the difference between the data consolidation and the data migration? Both are the same thing.
Both are same thing.
Same thing. Yes, anybody want to say both are the same things?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Then yes, Gayatri, what is the difference? No. Yes, carry on. Well, before that, tell me,
data transfer
consolidation agodar hoil ka migration agodar hoil?
Migration
hoil.
Now let me tell you to take me to the consolidation again. See here, what I told you, the data consolidation is nothing but data is generated from many disparate sources. First point that we have discussed, from which sources data is getting generated?
Disparate sources
manje kutle sources apan je initially baghitle the, barobar na? Let me take you to that point also. These are the disparate sources. Yes or no? from where the data is getting generated. Yeah, correct na? So data consolidation manje kay, yes, sagalyankadun data collect karne. Got the point?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now you, I hope you got, you have got the difference between the consolidation and the migration. Barobar na? Consolidation manje kay, ki tya sagalya source karun data kay karne, collect karne. Ani mag migration tyachyanantar hoil na? Getting my point? हे जे डिफरंट डिपार्टमेंट्स आहेत जे सेल्स म्हणा परचेस म्हणा त्याच्यानंतर अकाउंटिंग म्हणा त्या सगळ्यांना अगोदर डेटा कलेक्ट करावा लागेल ना त्याला म्हणायचं डेटा कन्सोलिडेशन गेटिंग पॉइंट आणि मग कलेक्ट केल्यानंतर ज्यावेळेस तुम्ही तो एकत्र करता कशाकडून ह्या डिफरंट डिपार्टमेंट कडून ज्यावेळेस तो डेटा ह्या सेंट्रलला येतो त्याला आपण काय म्हणतो मायग्रेशन गॉट द पॉइंट
Yes, sir.
Got the difference between the migration and the consolidation? Which one happened first?
Consolidation
happened first. So process of आपण जे कलेक्ट करतो डेटा टुगेदर त्याला काय म्हणतो आपण कन्सोलिडेशन हे तर काय पॉइंट आपण डिस्कस करतोय सुरुवातीला ऑलरेडी आपण जनरल थिंग डिस्कस केल्या पण नंतर फक्त ह्या त्याच गोष्टी मी तुम्हाला काय करतोय आपण पॉइंट वाईज आय हॅव पुट दॅट थिंग्स इन द टेक्निकल टर्म्स इन द डिफरंट पॉइंट येस And so our last technique related with the managing the data sort is the cleansing. It is what? Data cleansing. Okay. Now data cleansing, when it happens, data cleansing, is all of you can able to see the screen? I lost the screen. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Our last technique, that is the data cleansing. Now it now data cleansing is the part of the analysis of data. Let me tell you the first point here. What data cleansing is what part of the analysis of data? Here I have mentioned data cleansing is the process of preparing data for analysis. Now how what things happen in the data cleansing? Modifying the data that is incorrect. Modifying the data that is incomplete. Modifying the data that is the irrelevant. Modifying the data that is the duplicated. These all the things happen in the data cleansing. Actually, this is being taken from the word data cleaning. Got the point?
Yes, sir.
So data cleansing is nothing but what? Doing all these things with data. If some incorrect data is there, need to get modified. Incomplete is there, need to update. Irrelevant is there, need to make relevant. If redundancy is there, need to modify it again. If in another format need to change the format etc so all these things happens in the data cleansing understood not these things also some important things that happen in the data cleansing that is the fixing the spelling errors syntax errors transforming into the standardized data set these different things are being done in the data cleansing got the point
yes sir
yes sir
ज्या वेळेस डेटा रिकन्सिलेशन होतं त्याच्यानंतर काय केलं जातं डेटा क्लिन्सिंग गॉट द पॉइंट दिस वन लास्ट टेक्निक यस अंडरस्टूड द लास्ट टेक्निक डेटा क्लिन्सिंग
यस सर
व्हाट इज हॅपनिंग इन द डेटा क्लिन्सिंग
सर म्हणजे जो इनकरेक्ट डेटा किंवा इनकम्प्लीट डेटा असतात ते अपडेट वगैरे करणे
बरोबर ना इरिलेव्हंट असू शकतो डुप्लिकेटेड असतो दिस काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स अंडरस्टूड सेकंड की जर सिंटॅक्टिकल एरर असतील एरर रिलेटेड विथ द स्पेलिंग एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा दिस ऑल द थिंग्स आर हॅपन इन द डेटा क्लिन्सिंग ओके अँड वन मोर थिंग इज ऑल्सो डन इन द डेटा क्लिन्सिंग की सपोज सम ऑफ द डेटा इज आउट ऑफ डेट आउट ऑफ डेटेड इज डेटा इज देअर which you can also refer as the can be data become out of date outdated data yes what do you mean by the outdated data yes outdated data means what
एक्सपायर्ड
की त्याचा आता काय आपल्याला उपयोग नाहीये देर इज नो यूज जर इफ सम काइंड ऑफ डेटा इज देअर विच इज हॅविंग नो यूज तो आपण क्लाउड वर ठेवू शकतो का
नो सर
किंवा आपल्या हे आपण क्लाउडवर सपोज तुम्ही क्लाउड युज करत नाही, कंपनी क्लाउड युज करत नाही, काय त्यांचं फिजिकल सर्व्हर युज करते, तर मग आपण तो डेटा इथं सिंगल ही जी मास्टर फाईल आहे इथं ठेवून उपयोग आहे का सांगा मला?
नो.
मग ते कशाच्या आधारे केलं जातं? डेटा क्लिन्सिंग. सो दॅट इज द लास्ट टेक्निक रिलेटेड विथ द मॅनेजिंग द डेटा रिसोर्स, दॅट इज द डेटा क्लिन्सिंग, वेअर वी प्रिपेअर द डेटा फॉर अनालिसिस बाय रिमूव्हिंग ऑर मॉडिफाईंग द इनकरेक्ट डेटा, इनकम्प्लीट डेटा, इरिलेव्हंट डेटा, डुप्लिकेटेड डेटा, मेकिंग द मॉडिफिकेशन रिलेटेड टू द स्पेलिंग इफ इट रिक्वायर्ड, चेकिंग द सिंटॅक्स, एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा. दिस ऑल द थिंग्स हॅपन्स इन द डेटा क्लिन्सिंग. आय होप ऑल ऑफ यू हॅव गॉट द फोर इम्पॉर्टंट टेक्निक्स रिलेटेड विथ द मॅनेजिंग द डेटा रिसोर्सेस. येस ऑर नो ऑल ऑफ यू?
येस.
वॉट वॉज द फर्स्ट टेक्निक?
डेटा मायग्रेशन.
ऍक्च्युली फर्स्ट टेक्निक मस्ट बी द डेटा कन्सोलिडेशन. येस ऑर नो?
येस सर.
I wrongly just I have put that sequence, but first technique must be the data consolidation. Yes?
Yes sir.
Yes, sir. Yes sir.
Second can be the data migration.
Yes. Migration.
Data reconciliation, and lastly the data cleansing.
Cleansing.
This question is asked number of times for the 8 marks. Question may not be asked directly. Explain the describe the managing the data resource. You might be asked question in the different way. Explain the techniques of managing the data resource. Or for the 2 marks also, question might be asked on these separate techniques. 2 marks question can be asked on this single technique. Explain the data cleansing, or explain the data migration, or explain the data consolidation. You are getting?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
So accordingly you need to prepare. So that's it for the today's session. Any doubt all of you in this point today we have discussed?
No, sir.
Okay, all of you need to go through once again when you upload the video, and so that you can get the more clear concept. Okay, shall we stop here now? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Thank you,
all of you. Thank you, all of you.